Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Song of the Ocean Blind. We're going to Mooth. Okay, not just quite yet. Sailor Dan says, oh, sorry. I'm in a hurry. Hey, kid, do you know which way is the road to Castle Enverin? Forte says, go to the plaza and turn north. Thanks, kid. Una said, he looked like a sailor. What's he doing here? So we'll see what's going on. I don't know if it's an optional thing or if we have to. Gatekeeper says, did I see the sailors enter the castle? Ah, those guys sent by Rish. They're so vulgar. But no, I can't tell you anymore. We are prohibited by the castle to give out any information to strangers. Okay, well, guess he's in there. We can't get in there, so let's go. Unless we're interrupted again. Yeah, it... there's water, though. Look at that. Look, you can see water. I thought we were getting on a boat. There's a ferry there, after all. Not interested, don't worry. Do not worry. I won't kill you. Maybe. I mean, we could fight them, but being that they're avoiding us, they'll probably give us really minimal experience, so it probably isn't worth it. We can't... look at that. It's like there's space to walk down a little further, but we can't... I can't make them go that way. Sure is a lot of you. Okay, now we got a bridge over Mooth waters. This is like the guy who named the place Mooth. It's like he had a lisp and he wanted to call it Moose, but... it was like Mooth! That's all I can figure. They got some strange names for these towns. Especially in Tear of Vermilion. No, not a Tear of Vermilion. Especially in Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch. But yeah, all of them have some strange names. Whiz. I'm not going back, am I? So now we're heading back the other way. Alright. Because we came up to that branch, right? So this, we're supposed to go this way? Alright. There is room to pass, okay. See, humans and monsters can live in peace and harmony as long as the humans are stronger. Is that the way to Mooth? Then what's up here? Maybe a chest or something? Oh! Rock crash. Hidden cave. Hmm. Well, my. I got a hidden cave. Punch it. If there's anything important here, or it just has like a chest or something. Huh. Okay, I guess we're going that way. Well, here is more than one chest. A freeze sword. Sweet. The little chest trick. Okay. Look at all the chests. Okay, lapis lazuli to sell. Uh-oh. Marbles. Let me look. Let me look before I get the last one. Sword with a blade covered with thin ice may freeze the enemy. Okay. But is it a good weapon otherwise? It goes down. It do go down. It goes down 4 points. Well, let's try it out and see how we like it, and if not, we can switch back to the other. Sudite, sudite. Okay, more marbles. Only throw them at monsters. I haven't thrown any yet. The chest is locked! No! Say it ain't so! We find a key somewhere other else. We came from there, right? From over there. Are you kidding? That's it for the cave? We need to remember this, and hopefully we run into a key at some point. Or a key runs into us. Well, that was interesting. So now this must be the way to Mooth. Mooth and Squirrel. Okay. I thought it was going to be a little cutscene with people talking or something. Mooth! Hello, green-haired lady. Troy? Maybe not a lady. Every port town is filled with energy, but Mooth is too quiet, don't you think? Couldn't say. We just got here. We used to have a lively community before, but now all the cargo arriving at the port goes straight to various other places. The shops and businesses are not receiving benefits, and the local economy is dying. I wonder where the cargo is going. Travelers come all the way to Mooth to get on the ferry, only to find that there's no ferry for them to take. What? There's no ferry? They have no choice but to return. We don't have enough facilities to welcome the passengers or offer them comfortable places to stay until the ferry arrives. We're causing them a lot of inconvenience. Troy has a lot to say. We can't even offer decent meals at our inn. We feel really bad about the situation. That looks like a female to me. Let's call you Deanna Troy. Hello. Supri? She's like missing a vowel there. Oh my, I have a headache. We can't get our hands on food supplies at all lately, and more than half of the items have been removed from the menu. We can't cook food, and the ferry doesn't arrive often. Yeah, I heard about that. We have a lot fewer customers these days, and business has been bad. I came all the way from Enverin to help. What's going to happen? I may be laid off. If things don't improve, not only will this tavern be affected, but the entire economy of Mooth will suffer. Is it going to be us fixing this problem? I have a feeling it is. No, that's not the end. This will ultimately jeopardize the well-being of the Principality of Pensola. I should make a direct appeal to the Duke. Good luck there. Well, maybe we'll end up appealing to the Duke. We had a terrible experience. The vulgar sailors took away all the food in the store, just like pirates would. They said that the food was for the party on Riotam Island. It's crazy. I must go and get some food, otherwise we have nothing to offer to our customers. What should I do? Go get food? Do you have money to get food? Head back to Enverin. I don't think we need to rest. Rick's just down a few magic points, it's alright. Yeah, we didn't rent the room, we just wanted to look at it. So we can come out this way. Goes down here. And then we talk to Rena. My grandfather, my father, and my mother had lived all their lives on Riatom Island. I don't remember clearly, but all of them, my grandfather, my father, and my mother, they all say that Riatom Island was a wonderful place, that it was a great place. I feel sorry for them. I'm bored. The place used to be filled with passengers getting on the ferry. I miss those days. While playing for the ferry, older boys and girls often played with me. Okay. Asuka says, I often see quarrels between passengers and sailors at the pier lately. The sailors are separating the passengers boarding the ferry. Who do they think they are, discriminating the passengers like that? We think they're hot stuff. Dead end area. Alright. Oh, hello. Rabbit? The sailors at the port have become particularly vulgar lately. They're no better than pirates. As soon as the ferry arrives, big fights break out between the sailors and customers at the pier. It's high time the soldiers of Enverin enforce law. People will get injured soon. Okay, so... it's a weapon shoppy. Right, he already has the soldier sword. Since he took that off to have the freeze sword to see what that's like. Hunter bow for Una. Bow for professional hunters, not so powerful, but ease of use is first class. Okay. They're selling the wolf's glove, but we found that out in the wild. What else? No one else can use shields. Okay. Yeah, it would get her that, but it drops her avoidance down by 10. And doesn't bring up the defense by 10. It brings the defense up for a lower amount. I guess all we got is this for Una, then. Attack up by 6, and defense up by 1. Exchange. We don't have a lot, but... Alright, soldier sword. Alright, maple bow. I'll sell the leather. That's it. Alright. Items? Doll Knight 8. What shivers the dark? Gotta get it. You know me. Before we cross that, we just look around. Taking the rest of this side. I think all these, I forget what they call these. These tie-downs. Nice detail, though. Oh, it ends there. Okay. Okay. There really is nothing else to see. We just gotta go across one of these planks. We'll be walking the plank. What? Oh, she's got an exclamation mark. Does the other plank come here too? It does. Yeah, okay. We'll go there last. Exclamation park place. Exclamation mark place. Actually, it is last. Nowhere we can go. Okay. Oh, we can go through there. They won't let us. We can't enter the pier without boarding ticket. The gate agent saying that, though. Please purchase it at the reception over there. Forte says, so we need boarding ticket just to enter the pier, even when we don't get on the ferry? Oh, so you're not passengers. Well, I know you're anxious to see the ocean. All right, then. How about leaving your boarding ticket with me? I'll return it when you come back. McBain says, that's a great arrangement. It's so kind of you. As long as you check your boarding ticket with us, you can enter the pier and watch the sea as much as you want. If I try to go... Hi there! Okay, he says that again. Welcome! This is the terminal for the ferry to the port of Polka in the Kingdom of Marcharose via Ryotam Island. If you haven't had an embarkation stamp yet, you must apply for one here. Alright, says McBain. Could you give us one then? Of course. Please show me your passport. McBain handed over the passport. Well, you're the McBain Company, right? I'll seal the embarkation stamp here. Sound of affixing a stamp? I guess. I don't know. Are you one of the musicians playing on Ryotam Island? Something like that. All we talk about are bad things, though. Here you are. Everything is fine. McBain receives the passport. May I have a boarding ticket, too? Certainly. The fare for the ferry is 40 gents. Thank you. That is the exact amount. Did we actually lose 40 gents? I guess so. Forte and his friends receiving a boarding ticket. Once you have passed through the gate, you can't leave the pier. If you need to shop or run some errands, please finish them before you go through the gate. If you would like to purchase a boarding ticket... I see that you already have a boarding ticket. The pier is crowded. Please watch your steps and don't get hurt. Thank you for your kind advice, Sazuna. Just want to see if you pull her string some more, if she says anything else. Nope, that's it. So, and he's saying I can leave it with him. I see that you have already purchased a boarding ticket. You can hop on whenever you want. So what was that whole thing about leave the boarding ticket with him? I mean, why would we go on and on about that when we plan on getting on the bond anyway? Do you have a boarding ticket? Yes, we purchased it, says Forte. Forte and his friends handed over the boarding ticket. Alright, you can enter. Enjoy the scenery as much as you want. Oh, we didn't look at it. Have you had enough fun already? You purchased a boarding ticket, so stay longer and enjoy the scenery. Oh, they won't let us back through. Which is okay. So we don't... He looked at it. Did he take the boarding ticket? Items. I mean, I imagine... Yeah, he did. Just look at all that water. Doesn't it make you thirsty? It's probably salt water. Una says, look, so many people are waiting in line. Let's ask the people in the line, says McBean. What are we asking them? We won't know how late the ferry is or how troubled the people are just by looking. All right, ask them when the ferry's coming. That's right, says Forte. We have to talk to all of them except these two. Sailor Pow says, what? Do you have anything to say to me? Luna says, why are you separating the passengers and party guests? You don't need to know, girl. Just be quiet and wait. How rude. Are you... Sailor Ryan says, are you a general passenger or a party guest? Answer me. Forte says, we're entering the audition at the party. You better be telling the truth. If you're lying, you'll get hurt. We were nominated by Ambassador Gareno of Buridine. Huh, you'll be okay then. Wow. What a surly bunch. Alright, alright. Wait in the line in front. Alright, let's talk to these people. Shalm says, I'm hungry. Grandpa, I'm hungry. Please. Grandpa Gossett says, please be patient, sweetheart. But I'm hungry. You can eat whatever you want once you get to Polka. Alright, I'll be patient. I'm hungry. I want to eat fluffy bread. Are you traveling with your grandchild too? McBain says, oh, you too? It's not easy traveling while looking after children, is it? I totally agree with you. Forte is not pleased. In my case, Forte, this one, is not only my grandson, but he is also my disciple. He doesn't grow up and keeps giving me trouble. I know it's tough training to be a performer. Keep up the good work. Yes, sir, says Forte. By the way, we've been waiting quite long. When will the ferry arrive? We don't know anymore than we do. Or at least soon. Mattia says, I remember you. You're the artist who were promoting the bakery in Enverin. Oh, right. She's the one who gave us a book. I think she gave us one of the Doll Knight books. And you were busy preparing for your trip, says Forte. I can tell you exactly. Mattia. Maybe it was with the Fred book then. Yep, Fred book 5, Chased by a Catapult. Given by Mattia and Enverin. Episode 41. You haven't boarded the ferry yet? Mattia says, the ferry hasn't arrived and the obnoxious sailors hassled me. It's not my day. Donk. Oh, I remember him. I don't get it. Why are we waiting on this side while Rish's guests are on the other side? Why are they separating us? Forte says, so that's what these lines are for. Those sailors made us form a different line. I'm upset. I can't have this now. I just want to go home and see my wife and kids. Well, I thought he was a kid. Musician Cyrano says, my name is Cyrano. I am a genius bard from Graysoul attending the audition on Riotam Island. Do you envy my talent? We have no idea what your talent is like. Nice to meet you, says Forte. Una says, we're also going to the audition. You must be joking. It's not a school play, you know. He's so full of himself, says Forte. Going to the audition? Take my advice and just withdraw. I hear that Balthazar, the piano prodigy with the International Theater in Cavaro, is also one of the musicians competing. It'll be a head-to-head competition between he and I. Really? Says McBain. The famous Balthazar will be there, too? Do you know Balthazar? I haven't met him personally, but I know his name. If you're invited, it's up to you to enter the competition. Do your best. Just don't expect to win. He's so full of himself, Forte says again. Eton says, I actually wanted to attend the party on my private sailboat. You have a sailboat, says Una? Are all the other party guests as wealthy as you? My sailboat is nothing compared to the pleasure boat Rish has. pleasure boat, says Forte. It's called the Banquet. The party on the last day will be held on that boat. It's a side-wheel steamer, so the boat can travel freely without wind. It's a very innovative vessel. In fact, I'm attending the party just to see the banquet. I can't wait to see it with my own eyes. Oh, I can't move. Okay. Sailor Dan says, sorry, I'm late. Ryan says, what have you been doing? No more dilly-dallying. No lollygagging. That's the one I'm thinking of. I had no choice. The Duke stopped me. Oh, he's the one we ran into when we were trying to leave. Just be quiet and wait. Dan goes, hmm? Your face looks familiar. Well, says Forte. Yes, I remember. You asked us for directions to the castle in Inverin. Have you finished whatever you were doing? Oh, that boy. Yes, it's done. Thank you. Are you also musicians by any chance? We don't look like musicians. We were actually invited to go to Riatom Island. I thought you might be troubadours, but I didn't have a clue you were so good as to be invited to the audition. Well, good luck to you. Well, he's a nice one, not like the others. Riatom Island is a great place. I highly recommend the casino. Really? They have a casino? Says McBain. What is a casino, Grandpa? You don't need to know, says Una. McBain says, you two are too young for that. Why not, says Forte. Please tell us. Don't keep it a secret, says Una. Dan says, so, Grandpa, are you going to enjoy it all by yourself? Haha, something like that. You're a funny guy, Grandpa. Other things you should do while on Riatom Island are... Ryan says, hey, leave it. We're not here to chat with passengers. What's that? Pow says, it's not worth it. Don't start unnecessary trouble. Ryan says, tut. Dan says, hey, look. The ferry has arrived. Yeah, it has, says Forte. Pow says, you're late. Nasty Sailor says, here, it's the guest list. Vulgar Sailor says, take care of the rest, will you? Huh. Nasty and vulgar. Luna mumbling, something is wrong. Nobody is coming out. McBain says, it smells terribly fishy. Dan says, we'll check the names on the list. Speak up your name, will you? I am Eton from the Principality of Pensola. I am Cyrano, the musician. Pow says, we have your names on the list. Right. Dan says, Eton and Cyrano. Board the ferry one by one. Well, there's no room for two people at once. Dan says, next. It's you guys. Wait a minute, says Mattia. You're only calling the names of party guests. Are you trying not to let us in? Ryan says, haha, lady, you've guessed it right. The ferry is overbooked. Go home. But why? I see plenty of room. Ryan says, we must carry the barrels and cargo you see over there. We have no space for people other than the guests. People are not happy. Donk says, don't fool around with us. That ferry is for everyone. Donk says, how can we accept such an unreasonable arrangement? Ryan says, shut up. We have permission from the Duke of Pensola. Ask the soldiers yourselves at the customs office over there. Pow says, you'll be in trouble, not us, if you stir things up. You just have to take it. The ferry service will return to normal once the party is over. Bear with us until then, will you? Oh, jeez. Hey, says Mattia. I mean, he sounded kind of nice the last two sentences he said. Ryan says, go away, go away. They're so high-handed, says Donk. Dan says, "You kids must be among the nominated musicians. Tell us your names." Forte says, "What you're doing is despicable." "Poor passengers," says Una. "Orders from higher up. We have little choice here. So, please give us your names." "We're not taking the ferry," says Forte. "What?" Una says, "We just came to check out what's happening. We bought a boarding pass." McBain says, "Oh, sorry, the kids are just confused. We're the McBain Company." "Una, we've come this far. Let's investigate a little further." "McBain, right. Can you find it, pal? Is it on a list?" "McBain Company. I found it." "No, wait. Look at the list." "What's wrong?" says McBain. Dan says, "Your name has a mark on it. It means you've already taken the ferry." "What? How can it be?" "Look, McBain Company from Letteratudo, right? You were nominated by Ambassador Gareno of Buridane." "But why?" "Well, perhaps..." Ryan says, "Don't fool around and do your job fast. If there's a mark on the list, it means one thing. These guys are a fake." "It's no joke," says Forte. Luna says, "We are the real McBain Company." Ryan says, "That's what every fake says." Dan says, "I don't think they're lying. The other guys may have used their name." Pow says, "We have no time to check. Sorry, but you just have to back off." "Let's go," says Ryan. "We can't afford to waste our time on them." "Hey! I'm sorry," says Dan. McBain says, "I have many things I want to say, but I won't give you a hard time. Thanks for your understanding, really. I'm sorry." "Get us on this boat!" "Leave it, will ya? Don't pretend to be a party guest. We know you're a fake. Go away and get a life." "I said go and get a life." "You did say that." "Alright guys, we gotta figure out what the hell to do. I guess we're heading back to the customs or the ferry ticketing office, something. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure."